Welcome to this Bend the Curve webcast. Bend the Curve is an educational campaign developed by NEHI with support from the WellPoint Foundation, aimed at providing healthcare leaders with actionable ways to reduce spending without impacting quality in an effort to create high-value healthcare. The campaign covers seven critical areas of wasteful healthcare spending and seeks to provide healthcare professionals with data to identify where costs can be reduced and recommendations for actionable solutions. In this webcast, we'll be looking at the problem of preventing medication errors. Targeting the $21 billion spent annually on preventing medication errors requires building on proven practices and implementing policy actions that target the root causes of the problem. These include using care coordination strategies, interdisciplinary teams, and information technologies, among others. But before we talk about the tools healthcare leaders can use to prevent medication errors, let's first talk about the size and scope of this very real healthcare issue. The Institute of Medicine, in its well-known report, To Err Is Human, estimated that 7,000 deaths in the United States each year are due to preventable medication errors. In addition, it's been estimated that each year in the U.S., a serious preventable medication error occur in 3.8 million inpatient admissions and more than 3 million outpatient visits. While the introduction and availability of new medications has improved the health of countless Americans, those same medications offered in error cost billions of dollars in unnecessary spending and claim thousands of lives. It's been estimated that inpatient and outpatient preventable medication errors cost approximately $6.4 and $4.2 billion a year, respectively. Prescription medication errors occur in all care settings, from hospitals to clinics, and in all steps of the care process. They may be the result of a mistaken dosing, a foreseeable allergic reaction by a patient, or an interaction with another medication. For example, dosing errors make up 37% of all preventable medication errors, and drug allergies or harmful drug interactions account for another 11%. In addition, prescription errors can be caused by fragmentation in care, especially for the complex chronically ill, and these can be exacerbated by a lack of information technology resources and data sharing. For example, only 13% of PCPs reported that they communicated with a pharmacist regarding new prescriptions, and EMR systems that are described as fully functional with a prescribing function were reported by only 4% of physicians. Preventing medication errors requires building on a coordinated set of proven practices in the field, coupled with policy actions in the public and private sectors. The following slides talk a bit more about how these proven practices and policy actions can help to address this issue. Care coordination and integrating the patient into the care team improves communication and provides more checks throughout the care process. For example, one study found that introducing a pharmacist on routine medical rounds led to a 78% reduction in medication errors. And another study discovered that adding a pharmacist to physician rounds in an ICU led to annual financial savings of $270,000. A renewed focus on the needs and abilities of patients is also required to address medication errors. This starts more generally through active engagement of patients and family caregivers with the care team, and specifically by adopting the Joint Commission's recommendations for medication reconciliation, which ensure that medications are reconfirmed and reviewed with the patient at each transition in care. New care delivery approaches must be supplemented with new technologies to catch errors, such as e-prescribing, EMR technology, and computerized physician order entry systems. E-prescribing systems, for example, have been found to reduce medication errors by 85% and create net cost savings of more than $400,000 a year in an ambulatory care setting. In addition, EMR technology has been found to reduce medication errors by 51% and create annual savings of more than $2 million in a large academic medical center. Another beneficial proven practice is pharmacist follow-up. Researchers have found that patients who receive pharmacist follow-up calls were 88% less likely to have a preventable medication error resulting in an ED visit or another hospitalization than those that did not receive follow-up. A number of tested policy actions have track records in reducing medication errors, such as increasing incentive payments. These policy actions include incentivizing providers and hospitals to adopt technology interventions like e-prescribing and EMR, as well as providing private and state payer-based financial incentives to use evidence-based practices that reduce medication errors. One final promising way to reduce medication errors that we've identified relates to bringing accreditation and certification requirements up to date. One way to do this would be to have specialty societies encourage providers to participate in the CMS Physician Quality Reporting Initiative, the PQRI, for documenting current medications in the medical record. Another way would be to set standards and require public reporting of medication errors as a condition for state licensure. That brings us to the end of this Bend the Curve webcast. We hope that the webcast has been enjoyable and informative. If you'd like a copy of this presentation in PowerPoint form, or you'd like to learn more about this or any of the other Bend the Curve topics, please visit the website at www.nehi.net/bendthecurve. On the website, you'll find the Healthcare Leader's Guide to High-Value Healthcare, policy briefs, PowerPoint presentations, and more of these webcasts. We encourage you to use these tools to educate your colleagues, as well as to identify and implement successful solutions aimed at addressing the very real problem of healthcare waste in your organizations and communities. Thank you, and take care.